Hello everybody. In this video, we are going to study some mathematical functions which are used in Java. So here the first mathematical function, that is power, P-O-W, and the way syntax of writing this is math.P-O-W. And here inside this, the two numbers whose power you want to find out. So here we have pass 2 and 2. So the action will be 2 to the power of 2, and this is going to return 4. Then the next function is sqrt x. This is square root of the number x. So syntax is math.sqrt. And suppose the number is 4, so this is going to find out the square root of number 4. So output will be 2. Similarly, we have cube root. This is cbrt, that is cube root. So math.cbrt 27. So this function will find out cube root of 27. So answer is 3. The next function is seal x. Here seal, this is going to round up. So here we have taken an example math.seal. Here m will be capital. So 24.3. What this function will do? This will find the smallest integer number which is greater than the value given. So here the smallest integer number, we will not take the fractional number, but integer number which is greater than this number 24.3. So the smallest number which is greater than this is 25. So this will be the output of this function. So this is going to round up. The next one is floor x. So this is going to return the floor value, or we also call it as round down. And what this function will return, suppose if our example is to find out floor value of 24.3, so this will return 24. So as we compare here and here, so this is going to return the floor value, means the down value. Over here the smallest value will be, that will be 24, and here this function, this is returning the closest integer value which is greater than the value given over here. Then next function is rind. This is rounding to next integer value. This function will round to the next integer value. So here, and this function will act, this will function same as we do, this will round up same as we do in mathematics. For example, here suppose if you want to find out the round value of 24.56, so the round value of 24.56 is 25, because here after decimal 5 is there, and as in mathematics we do that, if after decimal we have 5, then we round it to next integer. So this function is going to return the same value as we do in mathematics. The next is absolute. This abs, this function is going to return the absolute value. So what is absolute value? Here suppose if the number is negative, so this is going to remove this negative value, and the output will be 25.6. This is known as absolute value of a number. If it is positive, then it will be returned as it is. But absolute value of a negative number is without this negative sign. That negative sign is removed. The next is maximum xy. So this is going to return the maximum value of the given two numbers. So here we have, suppose we have two numbers, 25.4 and 26.6. So the maximum value among this is 26.6. So this is going to return the maximum value. And the next function is minimum x comma y. So this is going to return the minimum value. So here the minimum value is, this will be minimum. So this is minimum. So this function is going to return the minimum value. So minimum value of both this value is 25.4. So this will return 25.4. So these are some of the functions which today we will implement in Java program. So here we are with the Java editor. Now all the mathematics function which we have seen just now, so we are going to implement this in this program. This mathematical functions in Java, they are present in lang, that is lang package, but as we know that lang package is a default package of Java, so we don't need to import that. And here I have used the scanner class because I'm going to accept a value from user. That's why I have taken the scanner class. So let's write the program. So this is the class name I have written. Now we will take the variables. So I will use float values also. So I'm taking the variable as double. Now in this, next I'm going to ask the user to enter a value. So for that, I'm going to create an object of the scanner class. So that is equals to new scanner. System dot in. Then we print system dot out dot println. Enter a number. Suppose our first function which we are doing now is that is power function. So for this we need two variables, two numbers. So enter a number. And then that we will accept it in variable A. So A equals to obj dot next double. One more number we will need for this, because we have to find the power of the number. So again we print this. So this we can copy because we have to take the power number. So I copy this. Enter the power number, we can say. And this one we can say enter a base number whose base and power we have to find out over here. And then this will be accepted in the variable. So this also I can copy. B equal to next double. So I have taken the two numbers. Now I have to write the function name. So x equal to math. This is the syntax of writing any mathematical function. So math dot power of x comma y. Suppose we have to find out, sorry, a comma b. So a comma b. So this will find out the power of a to the power of b. Now we will print this system dot out dot println. Power of the number is, or whatever you want you can print over here, equals to plus x. So here our program is complete. Now next we will compile this. Here one semicolon is missing. So next compile. Here we can see no syntax error. Now we'll check the output of this program. Enter a base number. Suppose the base number is 2. Enter the power number. Suppose we want 2 to the power of 3. What is that? So the power of the number is 8. So this is how we have done, or we have found the first function has been done. Now the next function is square root. So for this we don't need any second variable, so we will do only with one number. So here I can put this in comment because these numbers are not required. Later we will use this. So now I have put this in comment, and this statement also I will change. Enter a number, I can do enter a number whose square root we have to find out. So here this will be math dot sqrt, and then this is also not required. Here we will write down square root of the number is x. So this is done. Let's compile this. No syntax error. We'll execute this program. Suppose you want to find out the square root of suppose 60. So you can see the square root of the number is 4. So now let's see the next function. Similarly, we can find out, we can use the cube root function. So that is CBRT, and here it will be cube root of the number is. So let's find out the cube root of a number. Here suppose we want to find out cube root of 27. So that is cube root of the number is 3. Then we will do the next function. Our next function is seal. So we are going to find out the seal value of a number. So for this also we don't need the second variable. So math dot seal a. So here we will write down seal value of the number is. So let's compile this. We close. We will execute this program. Suppose you want to find out seal value of 34.56. Here you can see that the seal value of the number is 35. Because just now we studied, just now we saw that the seal value of a number is the nearest, smallest integer number which is greater than the given value. So the smallest number which is greater than this given value is 35. So this is our answer. This is the seal value. Next we will find out the floor. Next we will see the floor function. So here we are, floor A. We write down here floor. Floor value of the number is. So we compile this. And enter number. Suppose you want to find out the floor value of 33.57. So here the floor value of the number is 33. So this is the, we will find the number which is near to this. So that will be the answer. This is the floor value. Then the next function is rind. That is, this function will round off as we do in mathematics. So we are going to first go to the editor, and here I write down rint, R-I-N-T. And here we can write down round of value of the number is x. So let's compile and find out this. So this will work same as mathematics. So suppose our number is 45.56. So here you can see that the round off value of the number is 46. Now again we will execute this program and check whether if the number is less than 5, means after decimal, what will be the output. So again I'm going to execute this. So this time I'm going to take 45.3. So here we can see that the round off value of the number is 45. This is same as we do in mathematics, but because here as the after decimal value it is less than 5, so this is round off to 45 only. This is the same one as we do in mathematics. So the next function, that is absolute here. And here we write down absolute value of the number is x. So we'll compile this. We close. Suppose I enter -56.7. Here we can see that the absolute value of the number is 56.7. Here this minus sign is removed. Then the next function is, that is maximum function. So for this we need two numbers. So here this, I will remove this comment part because I'm going to use this, these two statements also. So here enter a number, here I write down enter the second number. The second number. So this have been taken. Now maths dot max, this is going to return the maximum number, maximum value. So a comma b, both the numbers will be passed and they will be compared. And here we are going to write down maximum of the number is x. So this function can also be used if you have to find out the greater of the two number, and instead of applying if statement we can directly use this function. So let's compile this. Now I enter the first number, let it be 25.6, enter the second number 34.5. Here we have maximum of the number is 34.5. So among the both these number, the maximum number is 34.5. Similarly, this minimum function will work. So let's see that minimum function. So here instead of max, I write down min, and minimum of the number is x. So let's compile this. We close. Here I enter two numbers. Let it be 26.8 and 25.5. So here minimum of the number is 25.5. So this is how all the functions of mathematical functions of Java can be implemented. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.